Hey guys, it's Elena. Recently, I released my dual color brushes for Procreate, which have had a wonderful response from the community. And since creating these brushes and the initial walkthrough video, I have developed some extra troubleshooting tips, which may be helpful for anyone who is using the brushes in order to get the best results. And since I'm not able to add clips to my previous video, I wanted to share these tips and tricks in this additional video. And this video is specifically to help you troubleshoot problems with my dual color brushes. However, they are also helpful tips if you're having any kind of trouble with your Apple Pencil, and in particular, if you are having trouble using any brushes that have a tilt function in them. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the first important tip for my dual color brushes, and also for many of my other brush sets, is about dynamic brush scaling. So if your brushes are looking something like this instead of how they are looking in my videos, so obviously this is completely separated and not good at all, this means that your dynamic brush scaling has probably been turned off, and it's actually a standard setting that it's turned on. However, for some reason it might be turned off. So you can check this really easily by going to the gear icon, preferences, and dynamic brush scaling. So it's turned off now, which is why my brush was looking like it did. When you turn it back on, then it looks correct. So that is probably the most important tip. Tip number two, it's important to make sure that your iPad is sufficiently charged. And if it's below about 20%, the brushes might start to look really jerky. And you can check how much percent you have up here. So I'm at 99, so that's pretty good. But if you are below 20% here, please go ahead and charge your iPad up quite a bit and then try again. Tip number three, if you have not tried restarting your iPad, that is always a good idea if you're having any sort of trouble with Procreate, with loading files, with anything at all. It can really help to just restart your iPad. So tip number four is regarding your Apple Pencil tip. So you can see the tip here. It's like this last little bit that's attached, and it's actually detachable. So first of all, if you're having trouble with the brushes not looking right, make sure that it's screwed on all the way, because you might actually drop it and then it would become possibly less screwed on, a little bit like that, but you wouldn't be able to tell unless you're specifically checking for that. There's been multiple times where I've been like, what is wrong with this thing? And actually it was just becoming a little bit unscrewed. So just make sure that is all the way screwed on tight. And you can check the tip and just look and see whether it's looking worn out. I think this one is a little bit worn out, but it's not super bad. But if you can see some of the metal coming through, then it might be time to change your tip out. And you can actually completely unscrew this, and you can buy some tips from Apple. They are pretty cheap. And then you can screw on a new tip and see if that fixes the problem for you. So if there is nothing wrong with the tip, it is screwed on all the way and it's not damaged looking, or you've just put on a new tip, so it's definitely not the tip. It might be that the Apple Pencil itself is damaged, and hopefully that is not the case. But I have heard from a few people who have dropped it, for instance, and then the brushes didn't work properly. Or, you know, they just got an Apple Pencil that was a bit damaged and the tilt just never worked. So you can test this before, you know, having to deal with Apple support. You can test it by going to the default Procreate brushes and checking the tilt function there. So if you go to a folder called Sketching, which is a default folder that comes with Procreate, there is a brush in this folder called Peppermint. So go ahead and select that brush. And then you can test holding the pen at a complete 90 degree angle from the screen. And you should get a really thin line. And now tilt it, and you should get a line that is not so thin and is more spread out. And so again, this is a 90 degree angle, how it should look. And then almost parallel with the screen, it looks different. If you are testing and you tried with a 90 degree angle and also almost parallel with the screen and it looks exactly the same, it might be that there is a problem with the tilt function in your Apple Pencil. So if that is the case, please go ahead and talk to an Apple representative so that they can help you further with, you know, assessing whether there's any problem and how to get a replacement and all of that. So I hope that some of those tips might be helpful for general troubleshooting with my dual color brushes or with any brushes that might have a tilt function in them in Procreate. For the second part of this video, I wanted to go into a bit of a deep dive about how to create a petal shape with the angled brushes in my dual color brush set. So this petal shape is the most fundamental shape when using the dual color brushes, so it is really important to practice it and to make sure that you're getting that shape right, because I think once you've mastered the petal shape, you will understand how the angled brushes work and you'll be able to control them to create other shapes as well. So the most important thing to remember about the petal shape is that it's not in your fingers, it is in your wrist. And if you're trying to twist your fingers around without using your wrist, you're going to get very sore. And that happened to me for the first couple days when I was trying to figure out how to use the brushes after I had created them. I got really sore hands, and I want to save you that trouble by just letting you know it's all in the wrist, as my fisherman grandpa would have said. So let's go ahead and dive into what that means. So I'm just going to choose a yellow and a red to make the petal shape. Oops. And I'm going to choose one of the angled brushes. Okay, so what I mean by using the wrist is that when you start the petal shape, your wrist is going to be like this. And then as you go down, it's going to end like this. So starting with the wrist on its side, we'll go up and watch what my wrist does. My wrist is turning as we're coming back down. So let's try that again. We're a bit zoomed in here. Okay. So wrist on the side, going up and slowly turning, coming back down. So I didn't push really hard. I didn't squeeze really hard. I just started like this, went up, turned, and went down again. And if you can master that, you can make any flower. So once again, we start with the wrist on the side. We turn the wrist and go down the other side. So it's also important to remember that even if, for instance, if I speed up part of my video or it looks like I'm going fast, it's always better to go slowly and deliberately rather than pushing hard or like straining yourself. Just be really, really deliberate. And just practice this shape over and over again. And once you get this down, you will start to understand how the brushes work and how to control the angles and how to create the other shapes from the worksheets. One more tip for using the petal shape or any shape with the dual color brushes. When you have done your first petal and then you're gonna make another one and you wanna go all the way around to make a flower, don't do it like this. Don't do it with your hand. Just change the screen around like this. Then you can make all of your shapes facing in the same upward direction, and you don't have to put your hand in a really weird position, like crunching your wrist around to try and make this shape in a weird position. Just move the screen and then keep making your petals like that. I hope that this helps to explain further how to use my dual color brushes or any other brushes that have a tilt function in them. how to troubleshoot if something doesn't seem right. And I want to make sure that everyone is getting the most that they can out of these brushes. So if you're still having any trouble after following the troubleshooting tips, please feel free to send me an email at hello@elenajensen.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.